We've all heard the expression micro-navigation. What is it? Well, this is just my personal opinion, so some people may disagree. I would say that micro-navigation is just very accurate navigation over short distances. That's it. So it's a combination of any of the skills that you possess, any of the navigation skills that you possess, and they're all applied at the same time over a short distance. The reason it's done over a short distance is there are virtually no cases when you have to micro-navigate over long distances. And if you think you do, then you need to have a look at your map and maybe brush up on your navigation skills. You know, micro-navigation can be done at the start of a route, in the middle of a route, or at the end. In fact, you can micro-navigate at any point along a route. As an example, I'll drop this onto your screen. I'm parked at this road junction that you can see on your map. Now, between me and where my car is parked, there's lots of wide open spaces, there's tracks, there's walls that I can use as handrails. In fact, once I get down onto the track, then it's a very easy route, you know, for anybody who can use a map and a compass. Just as a thing, I took a photograph on the way up here. I'll just drop this onto your screen to show you where I am now. Now, you may end up in an area like this, you know, due to a navigation error, or you may end up here due to really bad weather and you just got lost, or you may end up here just because you intended to get here for a picnic. And to get away from this type of area in these type of conditions is absolutely, you know, it's really simple. But at night time, it's totally different. Before the easy sections on the track, I need to actually get down to the track, and that's a bit of a problem because at the moment I'm surrounded by very large drops, so I need to navigate accurately over a short distance. In other words, I need to micro-navigate from here to the track. Now, also in this situation, I can't just have a look at my map. I actually really need to study it and to make sure I know as much about the route as, you know, that I'm going to follow as I possibly can. So what I'm going to do is I'll use the magnifying section on my compass. I'll drop this onto your screen. Now, from here, I don't even want to try and climb over any dry stone walls in the night. If I wouldn't do it in the daytime, I definitely don't want to do it at night. So I think I'll head for this small break between the wall and the end of the cliff, just near the track. As there's crags and cliffs in all directions, the only way to get from here to the break, as I said, is to make a plan and follow it. So what I need to do is I need to take some very accurate compass bearings and then work out how far I need to travel on each compass bearing. And because you can't use timing in terrain like this, I'll need to use pacing, you know, just to check how far I've walked. Now, I don't know how to put this. In this situation, if you find yourself in this situation, then you definitely need to have confidence in your own ability to micro-navigate. And if you don't feel comfortable doing this in this type of area, you know, because of the very serious danger of dropping off a cliff, I really would suggest that, you know, just sit down, put all your clothing on that you've got in your rucksack, have a warm drink out of your flask, you know, so you can keep as warm as you can. Just sit down and wait till morning. But I think I'll give it a try. I mean, what can possibly go wrong? I shouldn't say that. So I need to head from here to the gap between the base of the cliff and the and the wall. And so from here, I've really only got two options. I'll drop this onto your screen. I can go to this break in the crags here and then up to the wall, just turn left and continue following it all the way around in a sort of half a circle until I arrive at the break. But that seems to be quite a long way to go. You know, I think I'll head to this small gap in the crags above me, you know, just because that looks like a better way to go. So let's have a quick look. So I need to be accurate with this. Here we go. I'll do this as accurately as I can. So I need to head on a bearing of 338 degrees, and I'm only going to travel
on that bearing for, let's have a look, 60 meters. Okay, so I'll set off and let's see what happens. So this is the gap in the small crags that were directly above me. Okay, so now I need to stop here and change direction. I'll take my torch off so you can actually see me. From here, hopefully you can see me now. If I was to keep going in the same direction, the map shows me that the very tall cliff that I don't want to drop off cuts in directly in front of me. So I need to change my bearing to, give me 30 seconds. So I need to change my bearing from, I'm gonna do this, from what I was doing. I need to go on a bearing of 10 degrees, but I only want to walk for 70 meters. And that should get me to the flat area, which is in that direction. So 70 meters, and then what I do is I'll turn left. So basically I'm going due west, and hopefully that'll take me down to the gap that I'm looking for. Let's carry on and see what happens. Here we go. And here we are. This is the track that you can see here, finally. So that's the micro navigation session over with. So what I need to do now is pick up some bearings, follow some handrails, you know, pacing across country, normal nighttime navigation. And hopefully I'll find my car, which is down there in that direction. So off I'll go. I'm definitely not suggesting that you go out at night time into possibly dangerous terrain if this is the first time that you've tried micro navigation. But I would suggest that you go out and practice. And today I'll give you a couple of examples of different types of practices that you can do and a couple of ways that you can do it. But first I need a coffee. In the last nighttime example, I needed to micro navigate at the start of the route. Now in the next example, I'll need to micro navigate in the middle of the route. And I would suggest, if you're going to do this yourself, that you practice in an area just like this. I'll drop this onto your screen. So I've chosen this area as there's a road to the north and the east, and a wall which runs all the way along the southern edge, and there's a major track running down the west of the area. So if it all goes wrong, all you need to do is you just need to walk in a straight line, and sooner or later you'll hit the road, the track, or the wall. So choose your practice area carefully. Now, I know that I'm somewhere standing next to this road here that you can see. I'll drop this onto your screen. So the road runs southeast, and I want to walk to, let's have a look, this wall track junction. Now, obviously, there are a lot of ways to do this, but today I'm practicing micro navigation, so I'm probably making it more difficult for myself than it normally would be. So I need to find something in the middle of what at first sight may appear to be just a wide open expanse of grassland, fells or moors. And I need to find something so that I can identify my precise location and then follow my compass to the wall track junction. Now, don't forget that micro navigation isn't just about taking compass bearings and counting your paces. It's a combination, okay? So in this case, our accurate navigation is finding our precise location, okay? And the idea of this is that once you know where you are, then you can take a compass bearing to where you want to go to. Okay, if you want to, you can pause the video while you look at the map. I'll drop it onto your screen. What feature would you try and get to that would tell you exactly where you are on the map? And remember that today we're talking about advanced navigation techniques. Did you find something? Yeah, there are lots of features, but I think what I'll do is, I'll drop this onto your screen. I'll head out to this flat area in the center. So I'll need to walk around 300 meters on a very loose bearing of somewhere between 240 and 245. And I'll know if I've gone too far because I'll start walking downhill. Now, what I'm looking for is the small bend in the contour line, which should be easy to find at an advanced level because it's the only contour line that has a right angle, and I need to go to where the north-south and the east-west contour lines join. So let's give it a try and see if we can find this very obscure feature in the middle of the moors. Yeah, this is it. This is the right angle bend in the contour line, right here. If you look behind me, there's this rise here above me, and on the left-hand side there is a flat area. So this, that way there, is exactly due north. So you can see the shape of the mound on the other side of the flat area, and that is where the contour line curves inwards. I'll turn the camera around slowly. And if you look behind me now, that way there is due west, and you can see the flat area there, and then there's a rise. So this here is exactly due west, that's due north, so this here is the right angle. Now, I'm not suggesting that everybody should be able to navigate to this standard, because let's face it, for most, you're not going to go looking for bends in contour lines, are you? Unless you're a bit crazy. But this is an advanced navigation sort of video, so, and we're talking about micro navigation. Now, from here, I can't see it, it's just an expanse. But now, what I need to do is I need to work out, I've got my location, so I need to work out my distance and direction to the wall track junction. Let's give that a go. We know now that we are exactly at this point here, the right angle of the contour line there, and we want to go to the wall track junction, which is here. So we need to know the distance, and we also need to know the direction that we're going to follow. So all we do is, you can use the parallax line if you've got one. If not, if you've got a different type of compass, you can use the edge of the compass. So don't forget, we know we're there. Let's use the edge of the compass in this case so you can see what I'm doing. And we will do this. So we put the edge of the compass so it's touching where we are and where we want to go to. And then all we do, rotate the compass until it is just about there. That's pointing straight north. Okay, so what we've got a bearing of 269 on our compass, which is just a fraction to the left of west. Okay, and our distance, it's 360 meters. So from here to here, so we now got our destination from where we are, we know it's 269 degrees. There's no declination in this area, so I won't adjust my compass, and we know the distance that we've got to walk. So that's micro navigation. As I said at the beginning, it's not something that you can go on a course and learn on its own. It's not a single technique, but rather it's a combination of lots of different navigation techniques all used together over a short distance. Which technique you use will depend on the situation, your abilities, your experience, and probably most importantly, what you feel most comfortable using at the time. So I hope you found this interesting, and thanks for watching.